Hello guys, welcome to my channel HVR Tutorials. Today we will discuss about an interesting topic, that is, whenever we are launching an Eclipse, sometimes we face this error. A JRE or JDK must be available in order to run Eclipse. This is the most commonly occurred error in the Eclipse. So when you are getting this error, what you are probably doing? Downloading a new Eclipse? That is not the solution for this. Even sometimes if you are downloading a new Eclipse again, still the error will not be rectified. So today we will see how we can fix this error. So here is my Eclipse and I will try to launch my Eclipse. So you can see the error. It says JDK or JRE is not available to launch the Eclipse. So what we need to do? We can fix this issue in two methods. So those are method one. Add JDK or JRE bin folder to the path variable. And method 2, add javaw.exe location in eclipse.ini file. So basically, whenever you are trying to launch an Eclipse, Eclipse will internally look for javaw.exe file. So if you haven't set any path like JRE or JDK bin folder path, then Eclipse will not be able to find the javaw.exe file. Then it will throw you that error, whatever we have seen earlier. So let me show you each method. So first we'll go with the method one, that is adding JDK or JRE bin folder to the path variable. So some of you might have a doubt that is it required to add only JDK path? No, it doesn't require, because Eclipse is looking for javaw.exe file. Javaw.exe file will be available under JRE and JDK both. Let me show you. Let me open my Java installation directory. So here is my Java installation directory. I have JDK as well as JRE. So when I open JDK, I have bin folder here, right? I'll just open the bin folder and you can see the javaw.exe file here. So similarly, let me show you with the JRE. So you can see the javaw.exe inside JRE as well. So you can add JDK or JRE path, okay, but it should be pointing to the bin location. Some of you might have already added the JDK path, but still you are facing this issue. Let me tell you what the reason might be. So when you add the JDK path, maybe you have added only till the JDK folder. You haven't added till bin folder. So when you add only till the JDK, it will try to search in these 12 items. So the javaw.exe will not be found. So then it will start throwing you that error. So what we need to add exactly is we need to add bin folder. So to add bin folder to my path environment variables, I need to open my environment variables here. Right click on this PC, go to properties, go to advanced system settings, click on environment variables. So search for the path variable here. So here is my path variable. Just click on edit and check if you have already added any JDK or JRE path here. So here you can see I have already added JDK path, but still I am able to face the issue, right? I am not pointing to the bin folder here. I'm just pointing to only JDK folder. So let me edit this path and add the bin folder / bin. Okay. Click on OK. Okay, okay. So now go back to the Eclipse folder and I'll try to launch. So now you can see it is not throwing any error and it is asking me the workspace location. So this is how we try to fix this issue by adding the JDK bin folder path to the environment variables. Now we will see the second method. So now I will remove my environment variables because I cannot reproduce the issue, right? So I'm removing my environment variable. I will leave it as it is, like previously, it is pointing to only JDK. Click OK. So I'll go to Eclipse. So now you can see I'm able to produce the error, right? So click on OK. Second method is add javaw.exe location in eclipse.ini file. So where does this file located in? So when you download an Eclipse, after unzipping the Eclipse file, you might see all these folders, right? So just below the executable Eclipse file, you will find eclipse.ini file. So this will store the configuration settings of the Eclipse, like where it should locate, javaw.exe file, everything you can mention in configuration settings file. In second method, we are not adding the bin folder path or anything to the environment variables. We are directly adding it to the Eclipse. The difference between method 1 and method 2 is, if you have multiple Eclipse versions, the method 1 will work with all the Eclipse versions. If you have Eclipse 1, Eclipse 2, if you have set the bin folder path in the environment variables, you will launch the Eclipse 1 and 2 without any error. But in second method, it is only restricted to the Eclipse. We are not setting the path at the system level. We are changing the Eclipse configuration settings. So only this Eclipse can be able to identify where the javaw.exe file is present. So if you open the other Eclipse, it might throw you an error because that eclipse.ini file is not having this javaw.exe file location. So if you are using multiple Eclipse, I strongly suggest you to go with the method 1. But if you are using only one Eclipse, then you can choose the method 2 as well. And some of you might be working in some companies where you might have the restrictions to edit the environment variables. So in that case, you have to obviously go with the method 2. So now let me show you the method 2. I'll just modify the eclipse.ini file. All you need to do is, before VM args, we need to add the javaw.exe file location. Okay. So here, click on enter and I'll write VM. Then, so I'll go to my JDK, then bin folder. I'll copy this path. Then javaw.exe, right? So I'll click on save. Now let me go back to the Eclipse and try to launch the Eclipse again. So the issue is resolved. So this is how we can fix the issue in two methods. Based on your needs, you can choose the method and try to fix the issue. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching my video.